Hey, what's up guys? This is Maciej from DiviPixel.com and today I would like to show you how to use the DiviPixel Balance module to create an amazing mega menu and use it on your Divi website in a few simple steps. Let's get started. Okay guys, so this is my WordPress installation. I have a Gardener DiviPixel layout pack installed here and I will show you how to use the DiviPixel Balloon module to build a nice mega menu that will be triggered when you hover over the element in your navigation. So let's get started. To do this we need to build our mega menu layout using the Divi builder. And to do this, just go to Divi library, add new item, put the name, whatever you want, and use section or row, whatever you need, depending on the layout you want to design. I have already designed a layout using the row. It's a row with two columns, so I'm gonna show you this and I would like to mention here a few important things that you need to do in this layout to make it working good with the Balloon module. So this is my layout. I used some native Divi modules like text and blurbs, and now what you need to do is if you go to row settings, the row will always have default width set to 80 pixels, so you need to make sure that you put 100% here. So this will take the full width of the balloon, and if you will need some additional spacing you can also add some spacing in the balloon module itself. I also enabled equalize column heights option, so I can add the background here to the second column and it's a full height. And I also removed padding from the row because by default it will also have like 20 or 30 pixels by default is added here. So I put this to zero. And this is my layout that I want to use in the Balloon module. So now to inject this layout to the menu, we need to place the Balloon module in the header or in the footer, so it will be available on all pages globally. And to do this, we will use Theme Builder. So go to Divi and Theme Builder. And here we have the default website template, so we need to click Add Global Header, Build Global Header. And I will use just a simple header with the menu module. It's a one column. Now just type menu and okay, I add menu module. Here you can assign the menu which should be displayed here. You can add a logo. You can also do some other customization like changing the fonts, colors. I'm just gonna do some quick tweaks to make it looking good. The logo is too big, so I will set this to 200 pixels. I will also remove bottom spacing from the menu module because each module in Divi has a bottom margin added by default. So I'm gonna put zero here. And I'm also gonna align this menu to the right. So yeah, now it looks quite good. I'm gonna also remove the spacing from the row, from the section, and tweak the row spacing as well. Maybe it's too big, so I'll maybe put 20 pixels. Yeah, so this looks good to me and I think we can go with that. Maybe just add some shadow as well to see where the header ends. Yeah, okay, so this is our header and our menu, so I'm gonna save it for now. And this is the menu that if we will save it we will see it on front end, so I'm gonna save it here as well. And now if you see the front end page we will see this menu here. And now we want to add balloon to the menu. So what we need to do is we need to add a custom class to the menu that will be the same as in balloon module. The balloon module we will add later. So now I will add custom item here with some custom link, and I'll call it mega menu. And let's say it will be the first item here. And now we need to add a custom class here. By default, we won't see custom class field here. And to enable that, we need to go to screen options and check the CSS classes, so we can see the CSS classes here. The class I want to use for mega menu will be DP mega menu. Just be sure to add some prefix or suffix and don't use only mega menu, because mega menu class is used in Divi already and it might cause some issues. So okay, so this is our class DP mega menu, and we need to save our menu. Now it's saved. So we need to go back to the Divi builder, to the team builder, sorry, Divi and team builder. Our global header, we need to click this little pen icon to open it again and make the changes we want. So what we want to do here is we want to add balloon module to this section, and I will add it just below the menu module. So just search for balloon, and this is our balloon. These are the module settings. So we need to add a selector here, and it is class DP mega menu. Okay, we want balloon placement to be at the bottom. We can change the animation, and for the content type we need to select the Divi library, and in Divi library drop down we need to select the layout we have designed and saved in the Divi library and which we want to use for the mega menu. So in my case it's mega menu layout. The interactive option should be enabled, so users will be able to hover over the balloon and click on the links. I will also add a little arrow that be white and background for the balloon. Actually it's not needed because we already have in the layout, we have a gray background here and one white background here for the first column. So what we need to do, what we see here, the balloon is very narrow and we need to increase its size. So in sizing, by default it's 550 pixels, so I want my balloon to be 1000 pixels. Now it looks good. I will also add maybe border radius and box shadow. We can see that we have some additional padding here in the balloon, so I'm gonna remove this as well, because I don't want these paddings here. So by default there is 20 or 30 pixels added, so we need to set 0 to remove this spacing. And now I think our balloon looks good. Okay, so this should actually work now, so I'm gonna save it and check on front end what we got. So save here as well and see on front end if the balloon works as expected. So yeah, this is our menu, this is a standard drop down, and here we have the balloon we have designed. We might have some problems with the mobile view, but I would recommend to do not use mega menu for the mobiles, and I will show you how to use different menu for the mobiles and use Divi Pixel mobile settings like full screen mobile menu, hamburger icon animation and everything else what's possible, because for now we have standard menu here, and when we hover here we will see the balloon. It is possible to optimize this balloon for mobiles as well, that it will be in one column. We would need to change the balloon width and it would look good. However, I think it's not good experience for users to have so many items and with so many things. So I will show you how to create separate menu for the mobile users. So to do this, we need to go back to the WordPress dashboard, go to appearance menus, and now click create a new menu, and I will call it mobile menu. We don't need to assign it because we will assign it in the menu module, separate menu module that we will add to the theme builder. So now I'm just gonna click the create menu button, and we have the menu, and here you can add any pages you want to have on the mobile menu. I will add just a few pages. Okay, let's see, four, maybe blog as well. Yeah, we have five items here, and click save menu button. Now we have the two menus. Now one is primary menu that we will display on desktops, and second is the mobile menu that we will want to display on mobile devices and tablets as well. Of course, you can maybe use the mega menu on tablets if you will want. However, I wouldn't do this, and I would create just a simple mobile menu for mobiles and tablets users. So now we have this menu created, we need to go to Divi Theme Builder and edit our global header to add a separate menu for mobile users. So to do this, we need to disable our navigation that we display for desktops. We need to disable this for mobile and tablets users. To do this, I will simply go to the row settings and advanced tab, and in visibility settings I will mark phone and tablet here, so it won't be displayed on phone and tablets. And now just save it, and I want to create mobile menu, separate mobile menu, so I will create one more row here. I can actually duplicate this one. So I have the module here, separate module for the mobile menu. Now we need to do the same here in row settings. We need to go to advanced visibility and disable this on desktops, so it will be only displayed on mobiles. Now I think this is all what we want to do. No, we need to change the menu also. So go to menu module settings and change the menu here to be mobile menu. And now we will have mobile menu here. This is our mobile menu. Maybe do some tweaks here for spacing, like 20 pixels at the top and at the bottom. So this is it. I'm gonna save it now, and we will see if this is working on front end. Now it's saved. I'll quit this, and let's see on front end what we have. Okay, so this is our standard menu for desktops. We have mega menu here. There is a problem with icons, but this is happening very often, and it's connected with the CSS file generation. This item is loaded from the library, so it's already not properly read. So to fix it, we can go to theme options, builder, advanced. You can enable static CSS file generation, and now disable it back, and let's see if this fixes the problem with the icons. I believe it does. So yes, we have all icons, we have the mega menu here, and now I'm gonna check on mobiles if it's proper. So here is our hamburger icon, and here is our separate menu for the mobile users. Okay, this is it. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I would like you to build amazing mega menus using the Divi Pixel Balloon module. If you enjoy watching this video, please don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thank you very much for watching and see you soon.